What's up guys, my name is Michael Coleman. I'm with Fishing with Michael, and today I'm gonna be showing you guys how to
cure up your own coon shrimp
for summer and winter steelhead.
All right, so starting out with like the ingredients or what you're gonna need is you're gonna need some sort of shrimp curing cure. I use the Pro Cure shrimp and prawn cure. I have red, magenta red, and then I'm all out of orange, but I also have orange, obviously. There's an option of bait dye. This is like fluorescent bait dye. You can add this to your cure and it just makes it so much more dark or pronounced color.
But all you really need is a bottle of this, purified distilled water, some salt, and of course, your raw, uncured, frozen coon shrimp. So first, I'm gonna take my jar. This is a 1-quart jar. I'm gonna take my magenta, my pink, magenta red. I'm gonna pour it into the jar until
there's about an inch in there. It's probably gonna be all of this. That's a little bit too much. I'll take a little bit out. So you're gonna want about 3/4 of an inch or an inch of the cure itself in there. Distilled or purified or river water. And you're gonna put it 3/4 of the way into the jar. The reason you wanna use like a pure clean water other than tap water or hose water is because hose water or like house water you get from your house has all sorts of chemicals in it that will kind of ruin your bait when you cure it. It won't make it right. All the water is gonna, the only reason you need water is you need something for all the cures and salts and stuff to dissolve into. And so osmosis can happen with the shrimp and that all that cure that is dissolved into the water can go into the shrimp and cure it up, make it all good and smelly for the fish. So that's the only reason you need water. There's no like scent or thing to it. It's just you need something to dissolve your cures into. You don't want a bunch of powder or undissolved cure in the bottom of your jar. As you can see, it's all dyed now. This is looking really good. I'm gonna add a little bit more water to it because you want there to be all of the shrimp. You want all the shrimp to be covered. You want to have the jar full of shrimp and all the shrimp to be covered. That's looking good. Now you can use ice cream salt, rock salt. Make sure it's non-iodized. This is better. This is the ProCure. This is a bag of ProCure salt. It's literally just salt. You don't need to get the ProCure bag, but I was at the store and it's what they had. And the cardboard boxes that the normal salt you get from the grocery store, that stuff gets wet and then it falls apart. So I just grabbed this because it's in a little bag. And you want a pretty small palm full of this. You don't want to make your bait too salty. About that's good, just a palm full. If you put too much salt, it'll cure up your shrimp really quick, so it'll be good. But if you leave it in the fridge too long, it'll make it too cured and it ruins the bait. Last season, actually this summer, I made a handful of jars with a little bit more salt than normal. And I opened those jars a couple weeks ago and they were like, the shrimp were like crystallized. There's way too much salt in it and it ruined the bait. So you just want enough salt in there to just keep the bait durable. But if you put too much, it'll make it fragile and then it'll ruin the bait and it won't keep over time. And now you're ready to put the shrimp in. And what I have here is uncured coon stripe prawns from Ray's Bait Works.
Basically, what you're looking for is a frozen uncured coon shrimp.
Don't thaw out your shrimp first. Keep it frozen. Because if you thaw it out, it'll make it a little bit weaker and it's just unnecessary. So throw the shrimp in the jar, frozen. These are still frozen.
So you're gonna open up your bag. You're gonna grab a handful. What I like to do is I only like to grab the best of the best, like this right here.
That's a beautiful shrimp. That's gonna fish great.
I'll throw that in. This one's a little small, but it'll still fish pretty good. Throw that in. Same with this one. This one's a little bit small, but it'll fish. This one, I don't like the open tail ones. They kind of come in the bag like this. I don't like the way that it moves in the water. I don't know if I catch as many fish on this. Like this one, in the water, it'll just spin a little bit with the spinning glow. But with something like this, the tail will be a little bit open when I put it on the hook, and it'll just grab more water and it'll spin a lot more. And I think it just gets more bites. So I put the good looking shrimp in there. Every once in a while you'll get one or the head is broken or something on it. I'll throw those away. But that's gonna go in the small pile. Just make sure you write on your jar what you put in it. That's very important. Cause you don't wanna go to the river with a jar that's unlabeled, catch a bunch of fish on it, and not know what the heck you put in that jar. So definitely write on the jar what you put in it. So if you go out and you catch a bunch of fish on it, you can be like, wow, that was a good cure. You can go home, bam, make a new batch of it, and then go catch more fish. So what I'm gonna write on this one was where I put pink, salt, sugar. This is a pretty basic cure. But I'm still gonna label what I put in it. So this jar is closed every day now for the next week. In the morning, I'll go in the garage, I'll flip over the jar. What that's gonna do is there's gonna be a little bit of undissolved cure sitting on the bottom of the jar. And I want that to go through the bait and continue to cure it evenly. I don't want the bottom of the bait to be all cured and the top to be like not cured all the way. So what I'm gonna do is every day, I'm gonna flip it over and then let it sit for the day. And then the next day, flip it over and just repeat this every day for a week and then alternate for a week. And after a week, this bait will be cured good enough to fish it. But ideally, like 3 weeks will give you, it'll make it perfectly cured. It'll cure. That's when the curing process basically ends, is like 3 weeks after you cure it or put it all together is like 3 weeks, 3 weeks to a month. After it's done curing, so what you're going to do is you're going to take your jar, you're going to take your jar of shrimp, and you're gonna pour off 2/3 of the liquid. But anyway, I'm gonna use the garlic one. Sure is freaking garlicky. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna add a couple drops.
Or a handful of drops. Ooh, what the heck? Mm-hmm. Good little decent amount. Take out 2/3 of liquid and then you pour in a little bit of your bait oil, and you're just gonna gently rotate it. And what's that's gonna do, as you can see, well, you might not be able to, but there's a little layer of oil, which is that scented oil on the water. And so you're just gonna rotate that around the shrimp and so it evenly coats all the shrimp. And then you take it out of the jar. Each shrimp is gonna smell like garlic. All right, so that's how you cure up your own coon shrimp for fishing for salmon and steelhead. Hopefully I taught you something. Hopefully you learned how to cure up your own shrimp and so that you can go out and catch some salmon and steelhead on your own bait. Cause that's always a plus, is catching fish on your own bait. knowing you did something right. Thank you guys so much for watching. Stay fishy and fish on.